सो ओके गाइज, लेट मी फर्स्ट टेल यू कि वट अप्रोच वी गन अ फॉलो टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चन इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज और इन योर क्लाउड प्रैक्टिशनर एग्जाम टू, डैट वुड बी वेरी बेनिफिशियल फॉर यू गाइज. सो द अप्रोच डैट वी वुड बी फॉलोइंग हेयर इज लाइक, वी जस्ट ट्राई टू एलिमिनेट द ऑप्शंस दैट आर नॉट फिटिंग इन टू आर क्वेश्चन, एंड इन द क्वेश्चन देयर वी वुड ट्राई टू फाइंड सम की वैल्यूज अराउंड विच वी वुड बी रिवॉल्विंग. सो विद दीज टू ट्रिक्स ओनली वी वुड बी, यू नो, मूविंग फर्दर इन ऑल दीज वीडियोज. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, एंड हियर इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. इट सेज, विच ए डब्ल्यू एस सर्विस शुड बी यूज टू रीड और राइट फॉर कॉन्स्टेंटली चेंजिंग ऑफ डेटा? चूज टू. सो गाइज, वन मोर थिंग, वैन यू गेट दिस चूज टू ऑप्शन, सो आई थिंक यू ऑल मस्ट बी नोइंग इट दैट वी हैव टू चूज टू ऑप्शन फ्रॉम दीज गिवन ऑप्शन, एंड इन योर एग्जाम ऑल्सो यू वुड बी एनकाउंटरिंग दीज काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशंस ओवर देयर, एंड देयर यू कैन हैव चूज थ्री ऑल्सो. सो यू हैव टू जस्ट गो विद द थ्री ऑप्शन फ्रॉम द गिवन ऑप्शन. सो ओके, लेट अस रीड द ऑप्शन फर्स्ट. वन इज Amazon Glacier, the other is Amazon RDS, the third one is AWS Snowball, Amazon Redshift, Amazon EFS. So what is it is saying is, so see guys, here we have two key values. The one is read oblique write, right? So one is this key value, and the other one is constantly changing of data. So here we have this two key values, so we would be revolving around these two key values. So let us first try to eliminate some options if there are any. So if I talk about glaciers, so what glacier is, so glacier is something, you know, which is yes, of course we can read or write our data on the glacier, but glacier is something which is related to data archiving. Now what glacier exactly do is, suppose we have some data which we have not touched for past, I can say, 3 to 4 months. So that data would automatically shift from S3 to Glacier. So Glacier is something which is, you know, I can say it as a data warehouse. So it cannot be used for constantly changing of data, and hence this option is eliminated. It can't be our answer. So let us now see for Amazon RDS. Okay, so Amazon RDS is something that is used for read and write, yes, and it is an OLTP transaction. What is Amazon RDS? RDS is relational database service. It is a OLTP transaction, and it deals with SQL, and yes, it is something which is constantly changing of data as it is OLTP. So yes, this can be our answer, one of the answers. This can be one of our answers. Now this, let us see the third option, that says Amazon Snowball. So guys, Snowball is something you know, which is related for migration of data from one place to another. If we have large amount of data, then if we want to move that data from one premise to another premise, then we use Snowball. So this cannot be used for constantly changing of data, and hence this cannot be our answer. So let us talk about Redshift. So Redshift is again something which I can call it as a data warehouse, database warehouse. So it is something like it deals with SQL only, but it is something which stores the data, which it is not a thing that deals with constantly changing of data. So hence this cannot be our answer to, and hence it is also eliminated. Now let us check for EFS. What EFS is? EFS is Elastic File Storage. It of course used for read and write data, and it is something which deals with constantly changing of data, and yes, this can be the right fit. Okay guys, so one more thing that I would like to recommend you guys is, like, it's always a better practice to, you know, go through the documentations and all. Like, you have to read for EFS, you have to read for Redshift, what Redshift is, what Snowball is, what RDS is, what Glacier is. It's a good practice to go through with the official documentation that are given on the Amazon site. And if I talk about cloud practitioner, then no need to go in depth with this document. You can just revolve around the peripheral level, and it's more than enough for cloud practitioner. But yes, if I talk about solution architect, DevOps, and any other specialization, you know, certification in AWS, so you need to deep dive in those documentation plus FAQs also plays a very important role over there. So it's always a good practice, you know, to refer these documentations and all for this examination. And hence, in this case, our options is one is, you know, RDS and the other one is EFS. So with this, let us move to our second question, and it says, what is one of the advantages of Amazon Relational Database Service, that is Amazon RDS? Okay, so let us first try to eliminate the answer. Now eliminate the options. So if I talk about second question, second option, it says it provides 99.999% reliability and durability. So this is something which is the property of Amazon S3. So S3, that I think you must be knowing, it's a storage capacity, bucket storage capacity. So this property is something which is related to S3. So we just blindly eliminate this option. It can't be our answer, as it is talking about database service here. So the keyword is database service. This is the keyword, and we would be revolving around this keyword only. So we just blindly eliminate this option. Now if I talk about option number third, it automatically scales databases for load. So guys, if I talk about RDS, so RDS is not something that automatically scales, but DynamoDB and Aurora, these two services have the property to automatically scale databases for loads. So hence this option is also eliminated. This is not the property of RDS. Now we are left with only two options. Let us see the first option. It says it simplifies relational database administration tasks. Yes, of course, it simplifies relational database administration tasks. So this can be our answer. And the other one is it enables user to dynamically adjust the CPU and RAM resources. Okay, guys. So agar yahan pe dynamically word nahi hota, to this can be our answer too. But since we have dynamically added here, so this cannot be our answer. Hence, this option is also eliminated. So RDS allows us to adjust CPU and RAM resources, but it doesn't dynamically allows us to do so. And hence, our option here is option number A. So let me just clear my hustle this. Okay, so the option here is option A, right? Let us now move on to our third question. It says the customer need to run MySQL database that easily scales. Which AWS service should they use? Okay, so now guys, keywords here are MySQL databases and the other one is easily scales. So okay guys, let us first try to eliminate the answers options if we can. So if I talk about option number D, that is Amazon Elasticase. So guys, here it is talking about database, and Elasticase is a totally different concept. It is not related to, you know, databases and all. So guys, we just blindly eliminate this option. It is eliminated. Now we are left with only three options, that is Amazon Aurora, Redshift and DynamoDB. So as I told you, like scalability is a property of Aurora and DynamoDB, and hence Redshift is also eliminated, because it has nothing to do with, you know, scalability and all. So we just eliminate our second option also. Now we are left with our two options only, that is Aurora and DynamoDB. Now Aurora and DynamoDB both are capable to scale. So we will see the second keyword, that is MySQL database. Okay guys, so always remember, when we talk about DynamoDB, it is something which is related to NoSQL database, and Aurora, Redshift and RDS is something that is related to MySQL database, and hence here we are talking about MySQL database. So Amazon DB is also eliminated, as because it is a NoSQL database. So in this case, the best fit is option number A, that is Amazon Aurora. So let us now move to our fourth question, that is which of the following is the concept of AWS global infrastructure and consists of one or more discrete data centers interconnected through low latency link. Okay, so guys, the keyword here is consist one or more discrete data centers. So okay guys, when let us try to eliminate the options. So the first option here says is we have private networking. So private networking is something which is totally a different concept, and it has nothing to deal with data centers over here and kind of interconnectivity and all. So we just eliminate the private networking as it is a totally different concept. So the other, now if you talk about availability zone, so yes, availability zone is something that contains that consists of several data centers. So this can be our answer. Let us now check other options too. So edge location. Okay, so guys, edge location can't be an answer here. Why? Because edge location is something like, suppose you have a business user and you want to avail services near to that user, then you will be using edge location, and it has nothing to do with data centers and all. So this cannot be our answer. Region could be our answer if availability zone is not here, because region is something which consists of availability zone, and availability zone consists of data centers. So if this availability zone is not in the options, then we're gonna go with region. But since availability zone is there, so the best fit is availability zone, and hence this eliminates. And the answer, the best fit answer here is availability zones, and this would be our answer. So okay, let us now move to sorry guys, I just forgot the count. I don't know on which number we are. So okay, so this is the next question, that is which of the following is a shared control between customer and AWS. So guys, you would be encountering these kinds of question too, like shared control between AWS and customer. I think you would be getting 2 to 3 questions on the same concept, like which of the services provided by AWS, or which of the services provided by which is the sole responsibility of your customer, which is sole responsibility of AWS, or which is the shared responsibility. So you would be encountering these kinds of question in your real exams too. So okay, let us see. The first option is, that is providing a key for Amazon S3 client side encryption. Okay, so guys, this is something which totally is a concept of client. It has nothing to do with AWS, because providing a key is something which only client can do, and AWS is not responsible for this. Okay, so now the next option is configure an EC2 instance. So again, EC2 instance is something that user itself is creating, and AWS has nothing to do with it. So now option C says environmental control for physical AWS data center. So guys, again, this is the option for that deals with complete AWS, and the customer has nothing to do with it, as because in their data centers no one is permitted to enter in their data centers. Only AWS can allow, only AWS can access those data centers. So this is something that only AWS can access, this is something that user can access, and this is again something that user can only access. So we are left with only one option, that is awareness and creating. So this is something that is the shared role of your customer and AWS too. So hence the best fit for this question is awareness and training, right? So this is our next question, that is how many availability zones should compute resources be provisioned across to achieve high availability. Okay guys, so whenever we are talking about high availability zone, then minimum of 2 availability zone we would be using as to get the high availability. Nowadays they are people are using 3 availability zones too, but minimum of 2 availability zones we would be using to get a high availability. So no need to check other options. The answer is minimum of 2 availability zones. Next question is, one of the advantages of moving infrastructure from on-premise data centers to AWS cloud is. Okay, so now what is the advantage of moving on-premise data centers to cloud? Okay, so let us check for first option, that says it allows business to eliminate IT bills. No, this cannot be our answer. At it doesn't eliminate our IT bills, it reduces our IT bills, right? So let us check for option number B. It says it allows the business to put server in each customer's data center. Okay guys, no, this cannot be our answer, as because data centers is nothing to do with, you know, customers, as it is not customers' data center. It has nothing to do with customer side. It is totally AWS control, and it so it is nothing. There is nothing. No term is there which we can say it as customer's data center, right? So this is totally a wrong concept. So this can't be an answer. It allows the business to focus on business activities. Yes. Yes, this can be the answer. Okay, so let us now check fourth option also. It allows the business to leave servers unpatched. No, this cannot be our answer. Why? Because, you know, because the business it doesn't leave servers unpatched. There are chances that you have to patch some servers for security purposes or some other purposes. So this cannot be our answer. And hence, in this case, our answer would be option number C. So let us check. Yes, now in next question, what is the low cost durable storage option for retrieving database backup for immediate retrieval? Okay, so the keywords here are, one is the low cost and the other one is immediate retrieval, right? So we would be revolving around these two keywords, and let us try to eliminate the options first. Now if I talk about option number C, so option number C says Amazon EBS. So Amazon EBS is Elastic Block Storage. So Elastic Block Storage is something that we can access with EC2 instance only, and so we cannot access it for, you know, retrievals and all. We cannot do it for this purposes. So it is totally a wrong concept in this case. We cannot use EBS. EC2 instance, Amazon EC2 instance store. EC2 instance store, I can say it as a, you know, our computer's RAM. So this also cannot be our answer, right? And we are left with two options only, that is Amazon S3 and Amazon Glacier. So guys, if we are given only one condition, that is low cost, then definitely Glacier would be our answer. But since it is saying for immediate retrieval, so here the Glacier cannot be our answer, as because Glacier are of three type. The one is, you know, expanded and standard, and the third one is bulk. So in expanded Glacier, the retrieval time is 1 to 5 minutes. In standard, it is 3 to 5 hours, and in expanded it is 3 to 5 minutes. In standard is 3 to 5 hours, and in bulk it is 5 to 12 hours of retrieval time. So immediate retrieval is not present in Glacier, and hence, since we need immediate retrieval and low cost, S3 would be the best fit over here. So the answer here should be S3, and let us check for the answer. S3, yeah. So the next question says is, which of the following is fast and reliable NoSQL databases? Okay, so the keyword here is NoSQL databases. So guys, just always remember ki whenever you see a NoSQL, you just blindly go with DynamoDB. So let us now try to first eliminate some of the options if we can. So since it is talking about databases and it has nothing to do with S3, so we just blindly eliminate S3, and now we are left with three options, that is RDS, Redshift and DynamoDB. So in question it says NoSQL database, and we know RDS is something that deals with MySQL database, so it cannot be our answer. Redshift is again something that deals with MySQL databases, and it cannot be our answer. So we are left with only one option, that is DynamoDB, and it is our answer in this case. So let us check. Yes, DynamoDB is the answer. Now, what is an example of agility in Amazon AWS cloud? So agility is something which says you will get more when you demand for more, and you will get less when you demand for less. So this is something which is agility. More you will get for more, less for less, right? So access to multiple instance type, no, this is not an agile system. Access to managed services, this is not an again agile system. This is the I can say it as a characteristics of AWS cloud. So using consolidated billing to produce one bill, no, consolidated billing is something, you know, like if you have multiple accounts and you want to, that your bill, you will get one bill for your multiple account, that is what consolidated billing is. Like you would be getting a single bill for your multiple account, and it has nothing to do with agility. So this cannot be our answer again. So we are left with only one option, that is decreased acquisition time for new compute resources. Okay, so this is something that is agile, as because suppose you are on on-prem and you are not using cloud. So suppose if you want some if you want more load balancers, then you just have to rush to your nearest store to purchase new load balancers, and then you can only scale, or I can say you can just scale your load balancers. So this going to your local store and coming back to your workplace and then again installing that load balancers and then using it or then scaling it, this all time is reduced in your agile system. So this is an example of agile system, right? So the best fit here is option number D. So let us check for this. Yes, it is the correct option. Now the other question says is, which service should a customer use to consolidate and centrally manage multiple AWS accounts? So guys, always remember, whenever it is talking about AWS account, it is something that deals with organization, as because IAM roles are something which IAM is something which is used to manage or create roles or users. It has nothing to do with accounts. Schema conversion tool is something which is used to migrate your on-premise data to cloud computing. Like if you want to migrate from on-premise to cloud computing, AWS schema conversion tool is something that comes into play. And again, the config is something that doesn't have to deal with AWS account, and hence the organization is the best fit here. So just guys, always remember, like when you're getting NoSQL databases, then your DynamoDB is the answer. And like if you are getting AWS accounts, then your organization is the answer. And if you are getting some warehouse and all, or you're getting some migration of data, then for warehouse you have Glaciers, and for data warehouse you have Redshift. And if you want to migrate data from one premise to another premise, then Snowball. So guys, these are some keywords that you can blindly go with the answers if you're getting, right? So always remember this type of keyword, and it can definitely help you out in your exams. So this is another question. It says, what approach to transcode the large number of individual video files adheres to AWS architecture principles? Okay, so guys, what it is saying exactly is, like, we have a large number of video files and we have to transcode it, and like we have to transfer it from one device to another device. For better understanding, I am taking it as like this, and we have to transfer it immediately. So what principle we would be using, like using a many instance in parallel? Okay, yes, this can be our answer. Like we are having 3 or 4 videos and we are using 3 or 4 instances to transfer the videos, then it's a very easy task. Like every device have to transfer only one video, and it can be fast. Yes it can be fast. It can be an option. Okay, so let us check for further option. Using a single instance during off-peak hours. Yes, it can be our choice, but it is not better than A, as because if customer demands from on peak hours only, like he wants to transfer those video files in peak hours only, then this option won't work. So hence this cannot be our answer. using a dedicated hardware can be our option, but it is not better than option number A again. And if you talk about option number D, that is using a large GPU instance type. So it is something which I can say it as a overkill. It is a supersonic speed. We just don't prefer this kind of speed. Like it is something like, suppose you have to go somewhere by train and a person came and he just say, instead of train, just use rocket to go there. So it is that kind of speed. So we just don't prefer this too, and hence it is overkill. So the best option that comes into play here is option number A, that is using many instances in parallel. And yes, this is our right option. Okay, so for which auditing process does AWS have its sole responsibility? So AWS sole responsibility is for, again, yes, here you can see physical security. So the best fit here is physical securities, as IAM policies is something which is managed by users only, and hence this option is eliminated. S3 bucket policies is again something which is managed by users only, nothing to do with AWS. Cloud trails and logs, again, which user manages, nothing to do with AWS, and hence the best fit here is physical security, because it is the sole responsibility of AWS, nothing to do with users. So let us check its answer. Yes, physical securities. Okay, so guys, I think that's all for this video lecture, and we have covered 13 questions in this video lecture that are the real past cloud computing examination questions for practitioner exam. And I think I have cleared all. You don't have any doubts in this video, and if you still have any doubts in this video, you can just comment me out, and I would be trying to reach as soon as possible to you guys. And thanks for watching this video, and stay safe, stay healthy, and keep learning. Thank you.